first, you're going to want to break the bead. Let all the air out of the tire first. I've used a valve core remover. And then I'll make sure the tire is completely flat. You might have to break it all around, or you can push down on it with your foot or your hands to make sure it's completely broke away from the seal. You do both sides, make sure the tire's free floating out. I have attached mine to fit into the receiver hitch of my truck. And you want to line the little finger up so you can go into one of the bolt holes to keep the tire from twisting while you're trying to dismount it. I'm using spray silicone for my lubricant. Go on around with it, kind of lift up and as you go around. And you're going to do that on the bottom as well. This is a smaller tire, so this is a lot easier than the larger truck tires. Okay, you want to clean all the residue left by the bead around the tire rim. And you're going to pull the old valve stem out. And you're going to put your new valve stem in. The tool I have that pulled the valve core out also will pull the valve through the wheel. You can see how I'm leveraging with some pliers. Actually, those are diagonal cutters. And you can have two dots sometimes. Sometimes you have one. Sometimes you won't have any. Go with the red one if you have a red dot. And line that up with your valve stem. If you just have the yellow, there should be a dimple in the wheel, and you're going to line it up with the dimple. And if you can't find one, just go ahead and line it up with the valve stem, and you can balance it later. Always make sure you get the tire in the groove. That's going to shift the tire the one way you need, so you can have leverage on the other side. And fill it up with the proper air pressure, and you're done.